Hey y'all, so getting started, I'm showing you everything you need to get started. You need a mannequin head or someone else's head or your own head in order to put the wig on. This herbal essence product is called Curl Boosting Mousse. It's just optional. You do not have to use it. I'm using it here just because I feel like it kind of brings out the curls a little bit more. But really all you need is a spray bottle of water, which is what I just held up. A comb, a palo brush, a little clip here, and that little clip there is just to hold back the hair. So is the hair bow that I'm holding up. Any size hair bow will work. And then this is the preferred size of rod I like for you to use on a long wig with long hair like mine, because it's like 18 inches long. And then these other rods, they're smaller, and I use those all around the hair. Other than just at the bottom, I use them, you'll see, in the middle of the crown of the wig, just to kind of give a more defined look. And of course, you need a wig like this one that needs to be refurbished. So it's badly in need of a refurbish. All right, you guys. So to get started, I want to show you how I do my mannequin head. I actually use a palo brush. And I comb all her hair back, just like if it was a human head, I comb it back into a ponytail. The reason I'm showing you this is because this is something you would do if you had either a mannequin head or just if you could imagine this was your own head. This is what you would do. However, I would, like I always do, suggest braiding your hair back. However, since this wig is a curly, fuller wig, you do not necessarily have to braid your hair back. You can just put it into a ponytail. Normally, I do rod my hair when it's on my head, but I'm going to do it on the mannequin's head today because, one, it's just a better show for you, and two, I have cornrows in my hair right now. So, and then the little mannequin head is just sitting there. Also, make sure that you have all your supplies right nearby you, and like a stocking cap, because you want to put the stocking cap on the mannequin head. This is not a step you have to do, but I like to do it because I like to make it as realistic as possible, especially if for y'all, if this was your own head or if you were riding on someone else's head. This is how you would put the stocking cap on. I like to pull the stocking cap back like that to where the hairline begins. And y'all, I actually end up putting super glue on the bottom of this mannequin head just for this video, and super gluing her to the table, because you know you got to make it work. You got to get it however you can. All right, so getting started, this is the Bobby Boss wig. It's one that I wore in my last video. It looks a hot mess because I'm be honest, I didn't take care of it, hang it up on the towel racks like I should have. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to attach the little clips there. As you see, I'm attaching the little clips that come on the back of the wig. I always have a hard time doing it, but there you go, they're attached. And I'm just doing that so it can fit very snug on the mannequin's head, and also so it can fit like if it was on your own head or if you were riding on someone else's head, so it could fit snug on them. So you're gonna put the mannequin, the wig on the mannequin's head. Make sure you pull all, see my little cornrows here. So you're gonna pull all the hair you know, from up under the wig. You're gonna do all that. See how much I love y'all. I didn't want to go any time without making videos. So since I had braids, I decided to do it this way. But anyway, okay, so here we are. I have my palo brush. Step one, I'm simply just gonna brush the hair out. So as you can see, all I'm doing is just brushing the hair out. I'm not really brushing it from the bottom up because it's already a hot mess. So I'm just kind of brushing it, you know, brush, brush, brush. Now that I'm about to get started with the actual rodding, if you look, the very front of this hair, the probably about the first 3 to 4 inches, it's not even a Shirley Temple type of curl. It's just basically the hair flipped, has one big flip in it. See how that is? Now, I never ever actually rod that front piece, only because I only use that piece once I get it all nice and pretty and curled to simply flip back. That's all I use it for. That piece, the only time I would rot it is if it somehow got strangly and it started looking rough. But that first 3 to 4 inches of the hair in the front that falls around your face, I've never actually had to rot that hair. So I'm going to do it on the other side as well. I part it about 3 inches back. And then if you actually look at it, it's still very pretty. It's still got that nice little soft flip curl in it. And I don't like to alter that curl at all. The only reason I part it and I separate it like you see me doing right now is because I like to have the hair organized. It just makes it easier when you section the hair off into different sections when you're actually rotting the hair. It makes it easier for you to see what you're trying to rot, what you're doing, if it's just a nice organized way. So all I did was part the hair down, and then I like to like take half of what I parted, as what you saw there. Basically, I like to basically rot in like blocks. So I imagine the hair being like the shape of a block. So then I take that shape of a block, like what you see, like a square. And that square shape is what I take and I actually rot. Now I'm brushing out all the kinks in the hair. That is crucial. Crucial, crucial, crucial. It's just like having natural hair, how you gotta comb and brush out all the kinks in it. Before you try to do something to it. Now I'm spraying it with my spray bottle, the top of it and the bottom of it. I was doing this right here just to show you, sometimes if the hair is not in too bad a shape, if you just wet it and comb through it like you just saw me did, it actually brings the hair back to life. But it can't be completely ruined. It got to have a little life left. Now I'm shaking it up. Shake your mousse up first. Then spray it in your hand. Now, once you get pretty good, I'm showing you that's how much you need of the mousse. But once you get pretty quick at it, you really can just spray the mousse directly on the hair. It just takes less time. The mousse, what it does too, other than help you when it comes to the tightness of the curl, but I feel like it also helps when it comes to, I'll explain that later. Right now, I am actually curling the hair. I'm taking the natural direction that the curl is going. See, that's curling under. I put the rod up under it. I start from the end of the rod. See how long the rod is? Now, I'm going to start from the back end of the rod. And I'm going to how it got that natural curl in it. I'm going to put that natural curl on the rod. And then, as I begin to rod the hair and go up with it, I'm going to go right directly over that piece first that I started out rodding. And then, I'm going to just simply roll the hair up the rod. Rolling it up the rod. Y'all saw that it was a few pieces that fell. See that little piece? It fell when I was starting to rod. Don't fret about that piece. Leave it hanging there. You can put it with like up there with those pieces, or you can ride it with another piece, or you can just leave it there if it's that small of a piece. So now, key is you want to bend that rod as tight as you can. It's kind of like you bending that rod so you can lock that hair into place. So I'm bending that rod, bending it so that I can keep that piece from like unraveling out of place. I forgot that I super glued it to the table. I was trying to turn the head. Okay, so that is the first one. Now, the reason I'm gonna keep talking through this for a few more is because each time I'm giving you different tips when it comes to rotting. Because it does look like it's pretty simple and self-explanatory, but it does have little tricks to it, tips and tricks that I want to share. So again, make sure that you're combing the hair out 100%, completely combing it out. I'm showing you here how this wig has like little short hairs hiding in it. If you can see it, it's like, what's that about? But anyways, so I'm using my hair bone now to get all the other hair, or my hair clip to get all the other hair out of my way while I'm rotting. Because you'll notice that when you're rotting, if you don't use a clip to hold all that hair in the way, other stray hairs is going to get into your rotting session when you're trying to rot the hair, and it's just going to be a mess. So I'm spraying the hair on both sides. Then I'm giving myself a little bit of that mousse in my hand. Apply the mousse all the way down the hair. It's not that necessary to apply the mousse heavily at the root of the hair as it is to the end of the hair. Be generous when you get to the end of the hair, simply because that's the roughest, most tangled part of a synthetic wig. So, okay, so I'm getting into frame here. So again, you're gonna start, you'll notice that with the wig there, okay, so what I'm telling you now is you're going to basically rod the wig. See how I am curling, using it, basically curling the wig up under. I was basically showing you that you want to rod the wig depending on the way you want the curls to flow. That's the easiest way to explain it. These little pieces, they fail because obviously they're shorter. So guess what? I'm going to put them off to the side and I'm going to rod those pieces separately. I'm not going to fight trying to get those pieces in here with this rod. Rodding does not have to be a perfect job, y'all. It doesn't have to be perfect. As long as you get that hair rodded, hey, you're going to be good. So there we go. I rod and get it nice and tight. And then I'm just making like a little donut so it can be real tight. Now, all them little straight pieces that had done fail, I'm just going to come back and rod those separately. Okay? Don't keep trying to rod hairs when they're different lengths or whatnot. I try to rod like length piece of hair when I'm doing this type of rodding. So, again, with these, the green and the blue, all them different colors, that represents nothing. That is just, though, I think actually those rods are the same lean. What you see me here is showing you how it's different lengths at the tips of this hair. I'm just using my fingers to kind of get those tips tamed and as one. And then now I'm just rodding the hair backwards. Again, I'll rod directly over those tips to kind of keep them set in. And then I'll start rodding down, going down that rod. So y'all can see how I'm literally moving that rod. As I'm curling it, I'm making sure that I'm not just rodding the hair all on top of each other. I'm moving myself ever so slightly down the rod. And there you go. All right, so now I'm applying the spray to the back piece. I'm just letting you know to be liberal. Spray a lot when you get to the back, because that's usually the most troublesome part of a synthetic wig, is the very back and the bottom near the nape area. So be generous with spraying that water on their hair. I like to get it pretty soaked. I'm putting my mousse into my hand and I'm applying it to the hair, more specifically rubbing it downward towards the end of the hair. You can see here I actually apply even more mousse to the very end of it, because it was very, very rough. It had pretty much lost all complete curl, as you could have seen in the photos. Remember, it does not matter what size rods you use on the hair. If you want tighter curls, you'll use the smaller ones like in the middle. If you want looser curls, you'll use the bigger size ones like these blue ones. It doesn't matter. Just know that the hair, when it's shorter, after you apply water and mousse, it'll fall away like you saw with this particular piece. And then you'll just come back and rod that piece separately. I usually put the fatter rods in the back of the hair where it's longer, and I put it in the front because I like looser curls right in behind the part that I didn't rod. I'm done. This is the final product. Again, don't stress about it being perfect. Doesn't have to be perfect. Just get everything rodded up in there. Hang that thing up on that towel rack. Let it sit for overnight. And voila, and this is what you got. Nice, full, voluptuous curls. Y'all gotta see, I'll side by side the picture of what it looked like. I was showing y'all my braids. So I actually have my braids on under here, because you know normally I have some of my hair left out in the front. I don't normally have it like this, but just for y'all, I put the braids up under my wig. Bye y'all. Check out my other videos, y'all. More coming soon.